Carey will start it off for our now two-time champions. Just a couple of weeks ago, to think they were nervous rookies. Not at all the case now. Sharon Rawson might be. This is Sharon's first time around for us. Mary Ligenza, married with a couple of children. And Mary belts down a 10. Now, the name Ligenza should be familiar to you if you've been watching for the past few weeks. Remember, just before we started the women's series, our defending men, who will be back in a few weeks, are Paul Ligenza and Steve Ligenza. Paul is the father of Mary Ligenza, and Steve is the husband of Mary Ligenza. So it's quite a family affair that we've got running here. I got one too many Ligenzas in there. I said Paul Ligenza. Mary Ligenza's, that's Mary Ligenza's married name. Her maiden name is Romani. Her father is Paul Romani, so it's Paul Romani and Steve Ligenza. Now I've got it right. It's much simpler when we get just one representative of each family here. Alice tried to set herself up for her first mark. They went down in a hurry, didn't they? A strike in the third for Mary Ligenza. Alice once more has brought her fan club along with us. Along with her. Alice from West Roxbury has 5 children, 22 grandchildren, and 6 great-grandchildren, so it makes for a noisy and, for the past couple of weeks anyway, very happy audience here at Fairway Sports World. Yeah. And there they go. That's what I meant about the noise. Mary is on a strike, so one more would fill out the strike and set herself up, possibly, for some bonus money. Mary Ligenza is married with a couple of children. She has an average of 114. She also has a spare right there. Now Alice on the strike. Goes a little wide, but she gets some great backdoor action. 6 so far. She'll get one more bonus ball. As Mary now works on the spare. Fills up the strike with 8, 46 through 4. Mary Ligenza with a great bid for bonus money. That would have been 3 in a row and $50, but Alice with a 10 in the fifth, 56 at the halfway mark. And Mary Ligenza finishes up with a 10 and 64 at the halfway mark. So we've got some pretty good bowling going on right now and a pretty good match. At the halfway mark of the opening string, we have Sharon Rawson and Mary Ligenza at 64, and our champions, Anne-Marie Lutz and Alice Carey, at 56, an 8-pin spread. We'll be back with part 2 of the opening string right after this. Okay, here we go with part 2 of the opener now. Anne-Marie Lutz, hoping to pick up where she left off last week. Able to come up with a couple of big marks towards the end of the second string to put it away against Chris Fisher and Shelley Carr. Good bid, but it wouldn't go. And Sharon Rawson on lane 29. Sharon is single. She's from Greenfield. Get to seven out of that. So it's a six-pin lead for the challengers through six. Sharon carries a high single of 184, a high triple of 419, and a 109 average. She and Mary Ligenza are representing the Westfield Bowling Center. Four spare now. And Marie trying to play it a little bit too fine. Takes a three box in the seven. So the challengers are zipping ahead here. A 13-pin lead with three to go. Sharon with a good shot at spare upcoming. Gets it though. Well, same bowler. They got a three in the seventh box. Comes up with a great shot for a spare in the eighth. That's what Sharon Rawson's looking at, trying to decide which way, which side to go on that piece of wood there. Well, she went right on it. No mark. So the champs are going to be able to get back in this in the closing boxes of the first. 90 pins for the challengers, 78 plus for the champs. Right on it, and seven on the spare, 85 through eight. It's but a five-pin deficit for the champs. For another one. Nope. For Anne-Marie Lutz and Alice Carey, our defending champions. And 99 for Sharon Rawson and Mary Ligenza, our challengers, a four-pin lead with one to go in string number one. Sharon's been getting some big hits, but no marks yet. Anne-Marie with a 10 for an opener, or a 9, excuse me. A 9 box for Anne-Marie Lutz and a 104, and Sharon does well to get that 10 and gain a pin and finish up the opening string with a 109. So Sharon Rawson and Mary Ligenza are challengers for the western part of the state, Greenfield and Feeding Hills, respectively, have a 5-pin lead at this point over Anne-Marie Lutz and Alice Carey, our defending champions. We'll come back and see if they can hold on in the second and deciding string right after this. Okay, here we go with string number two now. Mary Ligenza will start it off. The challengers hold a 5-pin lead. And maybe a backdoor strike here. No, it'll be 9. As they just kept on dropping. Only the hit pin, and there it goes. Mary opens up with a spare. Now Alice Carey comes in here with a 109 average. She has a high single of 161 and a high triple of 375. And Alice opens up with a 7. On the spare, thin hit. Only 3. Well, Alice only has 3 to pick up, but they're kind of spread out. Nope, no help from the wood. So no marks yet in string number 2 for our champs. I can't imagine 2 bowlers who've had more fun in the 3 weeks they've been on than Alice and Anne-Marie Lutz. And like a couple of teenagers hopping around here. We'll see how long it can continue. As Mary Ligenza winds up with a spread eagle. See if she can clip both wings here. Now gets 2/3 of one of them. Alice for spare. Right now, it's a 10-pin lead with 8 to go for the challengers, Mary Ligenza and Sharon Rawson. Alice with a 7 and 24 through 3. So now it's an 11-pin difference. Kind of the same deal that Alice has been winding up with. A lot of wood, but still kind of spread out. We'll see if this one can go. Nope. Mary with a 9. And 39 through 4. Alice picks up 1 pin anyway. And the lead for the challengers now is back to 10 with 6 to go. Coming up next week, Marianne Weaver of Webster, Massachusetts, and Linda Menard, whose husband Jerry has been a frequent visitor on our shows from North Grosvenordale, Connecticut. Now Alice winds up with the spread eagle. Went right through the eagle's mouth the last time. Let's see where this one winds up. Well, she takes off the left side, so she gets out of it with a 7 anyway. And 41 through 5. Mary with a 6 and 45. So it's only a 9-pin difference and still 5 to go. So up to Anne-Marie Lutz to come back here and up to Sharon Rawson to hold on. Sharon gets a 9, and Anne-Marie with a 10. So, pin by pin, the champs come back. Overall, the lead is 8 pins now, with 4 to go. Big hit, but a tough leave. Thank you. Anne Marie might be one of the most animated bowlers we've had. She has made some great reaction shots after some hits like that. Sharon takes a six, so things have suddenly and dramatically turned around here. The challenger's at 60, the champ's at 61 plus. On the spare, seven. So the champs move into the lead. Sharon takes an eight. Anne-Marie takes an eight. So here's the deal, with two to go, 68 for the challenger, 76 for the champions. Overall, it's a three-pin lead for the champions, but Sharon Rawson blows them all away in the ninth. Anne-Marie with three horsemen, left side. She knew it as soon as she let it go. So we'll come down to the final box with quite a match on our hands. Anne-Marie takes the 10, 86. On the strike, the diamond is left. Two of them, so eight on the strike. She needs this, and it won't go. Almost up to the head pin. So we'll have new champions. Came down to the wire, and Sharon Rawson able to come up with a big strike on the ninth that settles it. We have identical scores in the second string, 95 apiece. But remember, Sharon Rawson and Mary Ligenza carried in a five-pin lead from the opener. So we'll add them up and see what we've got here for our challengers from out west, Sharon Rawson and Mary Ligenza, a second string 95, added to an opening string 109 for a two-string total of 204. And for our now ex-champions, Anne-Marie Lutz of Foxborough and Alice Carey of West Roxbury, 95 to go with an opening 104 and a 199 total. So by five pins, we get new champions. We'll be back with all our champs, new and old, right after this. For the last 3 weeks, and I finally blow it here. So did you have fun while you were here?
I had a marvelous time. It was great. Great show, and I really enjoyed being on the show.
Okay, now, Anne-Marie, we could tell by your reactions whenever you got a spare or a strike that you enjoyed yourself, right?
That's right. So I go out, my children usually say, you go bowling, you know, so I enjoyed the game, you know, it was fun.
Okay, great. Well, hopefully we'll see you back again, all right?
Oh, we're going to try.
Well, you can pad our studio audience with your 22 grandchildren, 6 great-grandchildren, 5 children, okay?
Even right, though, yeah. Right.
Will
not
they come
to mention
even
a mother who was still alive, 95, God bless her.
Okay, geez, that's great. Well, hopefully we'll see you again. Okay,
okay,
Alice Carey and Anne-Marie Lutz, say goodbye. And Mary Ligenza and Sharon Rawson. Now, Sharon, I know this is your first time, so you don't want to talk, so we'll start with you. What's it like?
I don't know.
Now, don't play the shy game with us. You didn't get any marks the first string, didn't get any in the second until the strike in the eighth. So you're just saving it up for the pressure moment there in the ninth?
Got lucky.
Got lucky?
Got lucky, yep. Yeah. I was struggling.
You were almost falling off your chair trying to pull her through there.
Oh, yeah? I know. She's capable, and she likes to wait to the last couple boxes.
So we're going to have to rename this the Ligenza Show now. We've got your dad. We've got your husband on the men's show. And you'll be around?
It's all right with me.
Okay, we'll have a lot of presents to buy at Christmas time in the Ligenza household anyway. Sharon Rawson and Mary Ligenza will be back next week. The opponents, Mary Ann Weaver and Linda Menard. I hope you join us for everyone.